Johns Hopkins Medicine is taking advantage of the benefits of solar power on 100 acres in rural Queen Anne, Maryland, about 60 miles from the Johns Hopkins Hospital campus in Baltimore. The solar farm boasts more than 40,000 solar panels.
This site produces 13 megawatts of energy, and on a hot summer day in Baltimore with all the air conditioning running, we use about 65 megawatts of energy. So on any given warm summer day, this will be about a sixth of our electricity of our overall use.
And what's good for Johns Hopkins is also good for the environment.
In total, it's roughly about 10 million square feet on the East Baltimore campus that the electricity serves. So that is the equivalent of 53,000 homes on our peak day.
The energy produced by these panels is sent to the power grid, and Johns Hopkins receives credits for that power and then uses the energy from the same grid to power its buildings. The deal is cost effective as well, with Johns Hopkins getting a guaranteed price over the next 20 years.
We might be setting an example for other hospitals. I think a lot of academic medical centers across the country have looked at the ways that they can be more sustainably supportive.
The solar farm is just the next step in terms of finding alternative energy. The campus already produces 15 megawatts of power using natural gas, and it has added a number of green roofs like this one to improve air quality and conserve energy. McConnell explains from a green roof on the hospital that medical centers are unique in their energy needs.
Hospitals run 24/7. There are a lot of things that you can do to be energy efficient in office buildings that close down at night, but hospitals don't do that.
It's yet another way Johns Hopkins Medicine hopes to innovate and positively impact the health of the community and the environment.